Welcome back to another very exciting tutorial here at the PhotoshopTrainingChannel.com. My name is Jesus Ramirez, and you can find me on Instagram at JRFromPTC. In this tutorial, I'm going to show you how to create and apply bokeh overlays in Photoshop. We're going to create these overlays by using photos that you wouldn't think would be good for much. We're going to use these bad photos so that you can see that you don't need high quality images to create good effects. By the way, if you're new to the Photoshop Training Channel, don't forget to click on that subscribe button for more free tutorials. Okay, let's get started. We're going to use this Adobe stock image, but feel free to follow along with your own image. The first thing that we're going to do is bring in the files that we're going to use to create the bokeh overlays. So I'm going to go into File, Place Embedded, and I have these two files here. We're going to start with the street. By the way, you can download these images from my website, PhotoshopTrainingChannel.com. If you're on YouTube, you can look at the description for the link to this tutorial on my website. So I have the street image here. I'm going to select it, click on Place. There it is. I'm going to click and drag the handles to stretch the image out so that it matches the canvas. Notice that this image is just a very bad photo of a street. This image actually came off my cell phone, and as you can see, it's not very exciting, but we're going to use this image to create the first bokeh overlay. Also notice that this is a smart object. That means that we can apply filters and edit them. So I'm going to go into Filter, Blur Gallery, Field Blur. Then I can increase the field blur. So click and drag on this slider, and you can see how the image gets blurrier. And I can start adding the light bokeh. And I can also add some bokeh color. And I can adjust the light range. So click on the black point, click on the white point, and just make the adjustments that you need to get something that looks like this. Then press OK. And you can see that this is a smart filter. If I double click on Blur Gallery, it brings up the Blur Gallery again, and I can make adjustments. I'm not going to do that, but I just wanted to show you that you could if you wanted to. So I'm going to cancel this. Then I can click on this icon here to collapse that filter so it's not on the way and it's a little less confusing. We're just looking at the two layers that we're working with. And what I'm going to do now is change the blending mode to screen. All the blending modes between this divider and this divider hide dark pixels and reveal bright pixels. So watch what happens in this dark area here. Screen, notice how that area is not really affected. I'm gonna bring it back to normal. Then I'm gonna create a new levels adjustment layer and clip it to the layer below it. Control Alt G, Command Option G on the Mac. And then I'm going to click the black point here and drag it to the right. Now we only have these bright areas and the rest of the image is black. Watch what happens when I select street and change it to screen. The black pixels are invisible and we only see the bright ones. So we can use this levels adjustment layer to control how the bokeh overlay looks. So I can make some more adjustments, something like this. So that's before and after. And I can also click on the street layer, create a layer mask by clicking on this icon, selecting the brush tool and making sure that I have a soft brush, so hardness set to 0, and maybe even a larger brush, maybe even larger than that. And I can start painting with black on the items that I want to hide. So I thought that highlight there was too bright, and now I'm using the bracket keys on the keyboard to increase the size of my brush, and I can keep hiding the pixels that I don't like. So that's before and after. I'm holding shift. If you shift and click on the layer mask thumbnail, you hide the layer mask. That's what that red X indicates. So now I can select this layer, hold shift, click on the one on top, press Control G, Command G to put those into a group. And I can call this layer bokeh number one. And this is what we have so far, before and after. Then I can go into File, Place Embed, and bring in this burger file. Again, it's a photo right off my cell phone. There's nothing very exciting about it. In fact, it's not a great image. It's just a burger, it's out of focus, but this is gonna work great to create a bokeh overlay. So I'm gonna go into filter, blur gallery, field blur, and I can make similar adjustments to create a similar effect. So adjust the blur, then adjust the light bokeh, and maybe add more color. So something like this, and I'm gonna press okay. Once again, I'm going to collapse the filter just so we could see the layer that we're working with. And I'm going to change the blend mode to screen. And I think it looks okay. We need to make some adjustments. I don't like this blue part here. Maybe this part's a little too bright. So I'm going to undo the blur. So what I'm going to do instead is I'm going to copy the parts that I like and use that for my bokeh. So I'm going to select the lasso tool by pressing L on the keyboard, or you can just select the lasso tool from the toolbar, and this is the area that I like. Right here, not the blue. And I'm just gonna duplicate it. Control J, Command J on the Mac. Notice that we just duplicated that section there. So then I can press V on the keyboard and move this around. Maybe place that here so it covers that part. And I can also hold Alt, Option on the Mac, click and drag to duplicate that other piece and hide whatever bright area I had up here. So now I can select all three layers by holding shift, clicking on the bottom one. So now those three are selected, and I can press Control E, Command E on the Mac, or I can go into layer, merge layers. So now it's one single layer. Then I can go into filter, blur gallery, field blur, or I can just simply press Control F since it was the last filter that I used. And there you go. Now it looks much better. I can now change the blend mode to screen. And this is the result that I get. I can create a layer mask again and hide the pixels that I'm not happy with. So the bokeh here covering her face. So I'm gonna select the brush tool and paint with black in those areas. And I don't want pressure sensitivity. So I'm gonna click on the brush panel under shape dynamics. Notice how I have pen pressure. I'm just gonna disable that. So in this case, it looks better without the pen pressure. So there it is, before and after. I can also create a new levels adjustment layer to do what we did with the other layer, or use something like curves. It doesn't really matter what adjustment layer you use as long as you adjust the luminosity of the layer. So I'm gonna make the darker pixels darker and make the brighter pixels brighter, essentially creating an S curve to add more contrast. So before and after. And maybe I need to click and drag this point to the right here. And of course, clip it to the layer below it. I wasn't using the clipping mask, so it's affecting the entire layer. If I use the clipping mask, it only affects the bokeh layer. So before and after. I'm gonna hold shift and click on both layers, Control G, Command G on the Mac, and this will be bokeh number two. I can select that bokeh number two group, and I can press Control J, Command J to duplicate it. And then I can press Control T, Command T in the Mac, right click and choose flip horizontal. And then I can move this around just so we can add bokeh on the other side. And I can move it to whatever area that I like. I can even rotate it a little bit if I need to. I'm just finding the right spot. I'm gonna move this just so we can see. So maybe right about there. And what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna hold Alt, Option on the Mac, and click on the layer mask icon to hide everything. And I'm simply gonna paint with white on the areas that I wanna reveal. So maybe some of that bokeh there. Careful on the sharp edges. So I'm gonna paint with black to remove that sharp edge. So that's before and after. And I'm just gonna change the name to bokeh number three. Notice that it really didn't make a difference in this case, applying the layer mask to the entire group, or simply applying the layer mask to the actual bokeh overlay. So it's up to you where you apply the layer mask. What I'm gonna do now is, on the topmost layer, I'm gonna select it and create a new layer. And with white, I'm just gonna paint right in the center, like so. And this is gonna be a sun flare that we're gonna put on the top right. Then I'm gonna press Control T, Command T to transform to get the transform handles. I'm gonna hold Shift, Alt, Shift, Option on the Mac, click and drag and scale this up. Then I'm going to press V on the keyboard to move this over to the top right, right about here. And I'm going to double click on the side of the layer to bring up the layer style panel. Then I can go into the blending modes and choose linear, dodge, add. Watch what happens when I uncheck transparency shapes layers. See how it's brighter and hotter? This is one of 8 blend modes that acts differently when you uncheck this transparency shapes layer. Also, the opacity and fill react differently. In this case, fill will work better. So I'm gonna click and drag the fill down to right about there. So it's still hot and bright. Then I'm gonna change the color by adding a hue and saturation adjustment layer. Of course, I'm gonna create a clipping mask, Control-Alt-G, Command-Option-G on the Mac, so that I only affect this flare layer. And I'm gonna click on Colorize. Notice the bar here at the bottom, that's the color that we're gonna be applying. If I click and drag the lightness to the left, make it darker, you see how the color is applied here. So that's before and after. So let me make this more yellow with more saturation. Something like that will work great. Maybe even bring down the fill a bit more on the flare layer. Or maybe even bring it up, see what looks better. Yeah, maybe a little bit brighter. So this is all subjective, of course, so whatever looks better to your eye. So I'm gonna select these two layers, put them into a group, Control G, Command G on the Mac. There they are. And I'm gonna call this group Flare. What I'm gonna do now is click on the model layer, and we're gonna add a little bit of color to her, just so that it matches a little bit better. I see a little bit of blue going on here and a hint of blue right up top here. So I want to add some of that blue to the shadows on her face just so there's a little more interest. So I'm going to create a selective color adjustment layer. Under blacks, I'm going to add a little bit of cyan and subtract yellow to get blue. Something like that. Just so you know, these are the colors that we can add or subtract. If we subtract the color, we get the opposite color. So the opposite of cyan is red, the opposite of magenta is green, and the opposite of yellow is blue, which is why when we clicked and dragged to the left on this slider, we got blue. So it's just a subtle effect. It's before and that's after. What I'm gonna do now is sharpen the eyes a little bit more. So I'm gonna create a new layer, and with the sharpen tool, I can sharpen the eyes. Make sure that you have sample all layers checked and that you're on a new blank layer. And watch what happens when I use this tool on her eyes. They get really sharp, which is what I want. Unfortunately, that also adds some saturation to the eyes, and I don't want that. So I'm gonna zoom in just so you can see what's gonna happen. So both eyes look the same, but we're only gonna focus on the left one. So that's before and after. Notice how the colors change. I want the sharpness, but not the color change. So I'm going to change the blend mode to luminosity and watch what happens with the color. See that? See how the color went down, but we still have the sharpness? So that's what I'm going to use. I'm also going to bring the opacity down to zero and just bring it up accordingly. So maybe 30% might be okay. So let me fit that to screen so we can see. That's before and that's after. And I think that's pretty good. So we'll keep it there. I'm going to end the tutorial by adding some noise, and the way that I'm going to do that is by pressing Control-Alt-Shift-E, Command-Option-Shift-E on the Mac to create a layer on top of everything that's a combination of all the layers below it. So essentially what that keyboard shortcut does is it merges everything onto a new layer. So there it is. Then I'm going to go into Filter, Blur, Lens Blur, and we're going to use the Lens Blur to add some noise. And you got to make sure that the radius is set to zero so that we don't have any blur. You don't want to add any blur at this point, so just make sure the radius is set to zero. You can just simply type zero on there. Then I'm going to reduce the amount of noise, and I'm also going to zoom in just so that you could see what's going on here. So look at the noise we have here. We have Uniform, Gaussian, Monochromatic. In this case, I'm going to uncheck Monochromatic and keep it at Gaussian. I can click on this box and use the up and down arrow keys on the keyboard to add noise or subtract noise. So I'm going to subtract noise, and I think right about 2 or 3 will be good. I'll leave the amount set to 3 in this case, and I'm going to press OK. So that's before and after. I know you can't really see it, so I'm going to zoom in. Before and after, fit to screen, and I'm just going to rename my layers here. It's a good idea to always name your layers. So this layer here was the eye sharpening, so I'm just going to call it eye sharpening. And the layer above that is the noise. I'm going to click on the noise layer, hold shift, click on the selective color adjustment layer, and then press Control G, Command G on the Mac to put that into a group. I can call this Bokeh Overlays. And this is before and after.
And that's it for this tutorial. I hope that you enjoyed it and that you learned something new. Make sure that you leave all your comments or questions down below. If you create an image using this tutorial or any other of my tutorials, feel free to share it on Instagram with the hashtag PTCVids. I often do a search for this hashtag to see what you're all up to. If I find your image, I will leave you a comment. Also, don't forget to subscribe and click on that like button. If you have a friend who you think will enjoy this tutorial, please share this link with them now. Thank you for watching, and I'll talk to you again soon.